question on what is metamorphosis. Answer: the term metamorphosis means a change of the form or nature of a thing or person into a completely different one. Question 2. When did Tiresias' fame spread all over the Ionian cities, who still did not believe in his prophetic power? Answer: Tiresias' prophetic fame spreaded all over the Ionian cities when his prophecy about the faith Marcius proved to be true. Pentheus, the Theban king on that moment, still did not believe in his prophetic power. Question 3. Who was Pentheus? Answer: Pentheus was son of Agave, Cadmus' daughter, and Ichon, one of the sun men grown from the serpent's teeth. Old Cadmus passed his kingdom to Pentheus. Question 4. What was the condition of Thebes when Bacchus first reached there? Answer: Bacchus reached Thebes. The festive fields echo with cries. The crowd all run, fathers, mothers, young girls, princes and people mixed together, swift towards the unknown rites. 5. By what epithet Pentheus addressed the people of Thebes and why? Answer: Pentheus addressed the people of Thebes as descendants of the serpent race. The five sun men or the warriors born from the serpent's son by Cadmus are the forefathers of the people of Thebes. Pentheus himself is son of Ichon, who was one of those super toy men. So the serpent was their forefather, and the Thebans are the descendants of the serpent. Question 6. How does Pentheus try to remind the Thebans of their ancestry? Answer: Pentheus calls Thebans as the children of the serpent and people of Mars. He reminds them that their elders sailing the deep seas seated their new establishment here, a refuge for their exiled gods. Their forefather, the serpent, gave his life for the sack of a pool and a spring of water. So Pentheus says, the Thebans should not surrender themselves to an armed boy, and they should make craven cowardly men run and maintain the honor of their country. Question 7. What kind of fall of Thebes does Pentheus desire? Answer: Pentheus of it is Thebes' faith to stand for only a short time. He wishes her walls might be destroyed by gallant foemen and their engines of war, that the roar of fire and the din of battle might sound against her. Pentheus comments, then they would be miserable but not sinful. They would lament their faith, not try to hide it. Their tears would be free, says, from shame. Question 8. What was the weapon of Bacchus according to Pentheus? Answer: Pentheus says Bacchus is an unarmed boy who takes no pleasure in fighting or weapons or the use of horses, but in mid-drenched hair, soft wreaths of leaves, and embroidered robes woven with gold. Question 9. What among the flowers of Bacchus was arrested by Pentheus' men? What did he say about his parentage? Answer: Pentheus' men arrested Aquates. He said that his parents were humble, ordinary people. Question 10. How did Aquates introduce himself to Pentheus? Answer: Aquates says that he is a man of Lydian parentage. His parents were humble, ordinary people. My father was a poor fisherman. Dying, he left him nothing but water. the only thing he can call his inheritance. But soon he learned how to guide boats, steering oar in hand, and to observe Capella and the rainy stars of the Indian goat Teget among the Pleiades, the Hyades, and the Arctic bears, the houses of the winds and the heavens for ships. 11. Where was the ship of Aquates heading for? Where did they stop by chance? Answer. Aquates recalls that his ship with other Lydian sailors was heading for Delos, and they were driven to the coast of the island of Chios by chance. Question 12. What was the name of the sailor who found out the young Bacchus in the island of Chios? Where did he found him? What was the condition of Bacchus' men? Answer. Ophlets was the sailor who found the young Bacchus in the island of Chios. He found Bacchus in a deserted field. The boy seemed to stumble heavy with wine and sleep and could scarcely follow. Question 13. What was the first impression of Aquates on seeing the boy? Answer. Aquates recalls that Ophlets led a boy with the beauty of a virgin girl along the shore, a prize or so he thought that he had found in a deserted field. The boy seemed to stumble heavy with wine and sleep and could scarcely follow. Aquates examined his clothing, appearance and rank, and he saw nothing that made Aquates think the boy a mortal. Question 14. Who was Lycabas? Answer. Lycabas was the boldest of the Lydian crew, and he had been banished from his city in Lydia for a horrible murder and was enduring exile as a punishment. He was the second sailor to undergo metamorphosis and was transformed to a dolphin.